California's Democratic governor, Gavin Newsom, successfully fends off an effort to oust him. Newsom survived a Republican campaign to unseat him over his policies on immigration, COVID-19, and crime. By late Tuesday, special election returns showed Newsom easily winning a majority of support from voters. Larry Elder, a black radio talk show host and supporter of former President Donald Trump, garnered about 43% of the vote on the portion of the ballot asking who should replace Newsom if he were recalled. Elder vowed to remove requirements for COVID-19 vaccines and mask wearing.
It appears we are enjoying an overwhelmingly no vote tonight here in the state of California. But no is not the only thing that was expressed tonight. I want to focus on what we said yes to as a state. We said yes to science. We said yes to vaccines. We said yes to ending this pandemic. We said yes to people's right to vote without fear of fake fraud or voter suppression. We said yes to women's fundamental constitutional right to decide for herself what she does with her body, and her fate and future. We said yes to diversity. We said yes to inclusion. We said yes to pluralism.
A report by the Financial Times says U.S. President Joe Biden failed to secure a summit with his Chinese counterpart Xi Jinping during their call last week. But the White House refutes this.
U.S. President Joe Biden proposed a first face-to-face meeting with Chinese President Xi Jinping in a call last week. However, the Financial Times reported on Tuesday Biden was unable to secure it. Biden later told reporters it was not true that he was turned down by his Chinese counterpart. A source briefed on last week's 90-minute call confirmed with Reuters, however, that the report was accurate and that, quote, Xi apparently intimated that the tone and atmosphere of the relationship needed to be improved first. China's embassy in Washington did not respond to a request for comment. The FT reported that Xi did not engage with Biden's idea of a summit, which the White House believed was partly due to the global health crisis. The G20 summit in Italy next month had been floated as a possible venue for their meeting, but Xi has not left China since the first outbreak early last year. The call between the two leaders was their first in 7 months. They discussed the need to stray from possible conflict amid the worst bilateral relations in decades. The White House said after the call that it intended to keep lines of communication open, but announced no plans to follow up. China state media reported that Beijing agreed to ramp up lower-level talks.